Tocando sua xere. Hey guys, welcome back. Got another request here, man. This is by K-Rino. You know, I'll be pronouncing his name wrong. I'm sorry for that. K-Rino. What am I saying? K-Rino. Want to call him a rhino? Yeah. Anyway, guys, this one's called Crucified. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Try 1,000 subs by April. Thanks for everybody that's subscribed since my last video. Now, I appreciate each and every one of you. If you want help dropping, pop it in comments. I'll get to it, man. Anyway, let's jump onto this one. See how we do with this one, because you know he's got some shit to say, this guy.
It's time for me to say goodbye to you. Forget a drive-by, get inside a car and drive through you. You can live.
Oh, what the fuck? It's tough about getting crucified anyway, so he's got fucking, he's got nails in his wrists. So these guys are trying to crucify me. So I'm not sure who's talking about. Might be talking about like the whole rap game or whatever. But he's talking about drive-bys. So I'm not going to fucking drive-by. I'm not going to shoot you. Just gonna drive off, yeah. I'll fucking run this car all the way through you.
Get inside a car and drive to you. You can live across the water. I ain't tripping, I'll fly to you. Incoherent. You don't know if you dead or alive, do you? Whoever said I wasn't one of the coldest lyrics to school you. Yeah. Whatever the so-called greatest can do, fool, I can do too. Most
this is, your guys are incoherent. Your guys don't know what's fucking happening. So you don't know whether you're dead or alive. He's talking about, you know, you think you're the best, whatever you can do, I can do too. You can do that, I can do that.
I can do food, I can do too. Most great lyricists are real repetitious, that's too true. Rap the same way on every song, every album, that's boo-boo. I'm a...
Saying fucking all these good guys, all these guys that think they're good, just do the same shit on every album. Same shit, every album. Every album. Fucking say he's bored of that. Just fucking mix it up a little bit, try some different shit. You know, if you've got a loyal fan base, they'll give you an album or two, you know, to practice some shit. They'll give you some time to try something different. Experiment. If they don't like it, you go back. Do your old shit, but do it in a different way. Don't just keep rapping about the same shit.
Same way on every song, every album, that's boo-boo. I'm a lyrically, scientific, philosophical guru. A master lyricist with the spirit of Shaka Zulu. I don't fly over your head on every paragraph to woo you. I rather consistently conceptualize and relate to you. Don't switch these
Why is he using so many big words? It's fucking Monday morning. Why is he using... There's no need to use so many big words at this time in the morning. Fucking visual or conceptualize, and what do you fucking say?
Guru, a master lyricist with the spirit of Shaka Zulu. I don't fly over your head on every paragraph to woo you. I rather consistently conceptualize and relate to you.
Alright, so it says I'm not talking all these fucking big words to woo you. You know, to make you think, to make you look at him in awe, as in fucking hell, look how good this guy is. Said, yeah, I'm a good lyricist, but I don't flex, basically, is what he's saying. Said, yeah, I'm a good lyricist, but I don't show it off too much. I'm not doing it to woo you. I want to connect with you. I want you to know what I'm talking about.
Conceptualize and relate to you. Don't switch these fake critics that speak on you like they know you. Don't let nobody dictate the style, young homie, do you? The same fool that's rapping about running a bullet through you. It's a sound, no ballerina wearing a fluorescent pink tutu. Why you...
Fuck you, we're talking about fake critics that are talking to you like the new, like they know you. Then he's saying that some guys that are trying to kill you wearing fucking tutus like ballerinas. Who's he talking about? Who's out there fucking prancing around like Billy Elliot? If you're from America and you don't know who Billy Elliot is, is well, quite a big film actually, wasn't it? It was in England anyway. It's about a kid, and his dad wanted him to be a boxer, but he wanted to be a ballet dancer. They got these guys out here with their guns looking like fucking Billy Elliot. Don't let anybody dictate your style. Don't let anybody tell you what to do. They're not doing it. Don't let them tell you what to do. If they can't do it, you know, he's talking about them critics, you know. I should have probably said it when I spoke about critics, but I didn't. But he's saying these fucking critics, don't let them tell you, you know, how you should be doing stuff. They can't do that shit. All they're doing is just fucking writing about it. I can't do it. You know, I'm not going to slay any of his music because I can't do it. Don't let those fucking critics tell you what you should and what you shouldn't be doing. That's rapping about running a bullet through you. It's a sound, no ballerina wearing a fluorescent pink tutu. While you spitting ideas and got people wanting to sue you. We was with your girl in the motel room, running a choo-choo. And she... Oh, what the fuck? So while you're spitting your ideas and having guys wanting to sue you, we've got your girl in the hotel and we're running choo-choo. He said him and his boys are running a train on your bird. Him and his boys are fucking your girl's getting it every which way from every guy in the crew. Every guy went through her. That's fucking hard. Girl in the motel room, running a choo-choo, and she ain't trying to leave to every member of my crew through. And all these years you thought she was sweet, innocent, who knew to try to. Is it? I don't know who he's talking to, but he's saying some shit to him. If the guy, yeah, that's fucking. If this is. I hope this is true. Well, I hope it's not. I hope this is true. He's talking to some guy now. It's fucking. He's done this. If this were a diss track, yeah, he's actually fucking aimed at someone there. And this is how he finds out that his girl's been cheated. Says, oh yeah, but fucking, she wasn't even wanting to leave until every member of the crew has been through her. She was staying. She was fucking gagging for it. That is hard. That's hard going, is that? She was sweet, innocent, who knew? To try to pick one best rapper is stupid to attempt to do. Like a fool who's stepping shit, putting their foot inside a new shoe. You was mentally stagnant in your audience, I'll fool you. I paid $100 to come to your show just to fool you. You wanna check and try me? you can't pick a best rapper. It must be. I hope he's talking about them fucking critics that just slay everybody for no reason. When they're out there, they can't do anything, you know. But it's fucking. I don't know who's talking to. I don't know who's talking about. But whoever is going at is going both barrels. Just like the dude's fucking girl, she was probably getting it every which way. He's talking about fucking buying tickets to someone's show just to go boo him. That's what fucking 50 Cent did to Ja Rule quite recently, innit? Bought all the fucking the front row seats because he found on like a discount site, he found some discount tickets, so he bought them all. And he fucking he bought all the front row tickets and he would just sat there. That fucking Ja Rule fucking singing to 50 Cent. That these critics can't choose the best rapper because there is no best rapper because you can't tar them all with the same brush, you know. They're under the umbrella of rap or hip hop or whatever, but they all do it a different way, don't they? They can't say, oh, he's the best lyricist or he's the best at spitting quick, you know. All these guys that make the music, all these guys that make the good music anyway, or the good tracks, they're all good rappers, you know. They're all the best rappers in their own way, you know. I'm not a critic, so I'm not going to name names, you know. If you look through my channel, you know who I personally connect to more as a rapper, because that's the person that I grew up listening to, you know. But that's not what we're talking about today.
Paid $100 to come to your show just to fool you. Want to check and try me, try me, survive me, find me, I'm blind.
Do you see, you're going to fucking check and try me, you're going to musify me? Like, fucking crucify, but with music. Musify.
I need, they be screaming, why me, why respect deny me, unaware that I be, lyrically, the coldest you doubt and reply, see, they want to check and try me.
He must be talking to someone with this, because he says it's lyrically the coldest. Yeah, and he says, fucking, if you want, reply and see.
Try me, survive me, find me, hit them blindly. They be screaming, why me, why me, deny me, unaware that I be. Lyrically, the coldest you doubted, reply, see. Under the radar, underdog, underappreciated. Underground, misunderstood and underrated. My natural.
How many different unders can you put in one fucking sentence? Underrated, understood, underdog. Did he say misinterpreted? That's not under, is it?
Oh, misunderstood and underrated. My natural love.
Underrated.
Passion for writing became jaded. I gave them intelligence, but the garbage they gravitated to the uninterested lame, and I cried and narrated through the multitude that hated. I maneuvered and navigated. They be hoping that I sell out and become integrated to this non-symmetrical imbalanced industry they created. People,
is he talking about fucking? Is he talking about getting signed? Says I hope I sell out, like not like sell out his music, but like be a sellout. He's talking about fucking maneuvering and navigating. Is that like when you try and maneuver yourself to the top or navigate your way through life?
Symmetrical imbalanced industry they created. People ask me y'all maneuvered and navigated. They be hoping that I sell out and become integrated to this non-symmetrical imbalanced industry they created. People ask.
Yeah. So he's talking about fucking selling out. And, you know, selling out to be mainstream, basically, I think is what he's saying, you know.
Imbalance industry they created. People ask me all the time, K, how come you never made it? It's because in lollipop world I never participated. When you hear my words, I want you to think and be elevated. How can my diamonds and my cars help your life get situated? You ain't saying.
Did he say, because he says, why didn't you make it? And then did he say something like, in your lollipop world, I never participated? He's talking about fucking. He's talking about like pop music, you know. Is he talking about like that fucking mainstream, like rap, pop sort of. That sort of shit that's in charts now. You know, like. That like fucking make believe sort of world. Is that what he's talking about? When he said that fucking lollipop, all I could think of is that Katy Perry fucking video with Snoop Dogg. Oh, what was that track called now? She had a fucking lollipop in that, didn't she? That's all I could think about then. Fucking Snoop Dogg in that track.
When you hear my words, I want you to think and be elevated. How can my diamonds and my cars help your life get situated? You ain't.
Oh yeah, so he talks about fucking that lollipop make-believe sort of fucking music, and he says, but when I want you to hear my words, I want you to think and be elevated. But like, I've got to do when I do this, man. You know, this weekend, I were going to do a video, well, my daughter wanted to fucking, to, you know, like, drop one of these videos with me. You know, so I said, you know, we'll sit down, we'll have a little listen through some music, and we'll see what you catch. Yeah, so I like listen to a couple of Yellow Wolf's tracks, you know, stuff that I listened to before, and every single fucking word just went straight over her head. But you know, she's 15; she's grown up with a culture of as what it is today. You know, what's mainstream today, and. You don't have to think of that shit, do you? You know, and just the simplest of bars just went straight over her head. And like, so like I was stopping the music every couple of minutes, a couple of seconds, you know, and saying, oh, do you know what that means? And she's like, no. I was like saying, "Oh, you know, it means just this, whatever, you know." And she, I am fucking going off track a little bit here, and I've said that I do that a little bit, but you know, she then started to get it a little bit, you know, about the difference in music, so like the different bars and how like you have doubles and stuff like that, you know, with the real people that make the real music, and obviously the stuff that she listens to, there's none of that shit, is there? Sorry, I went off track a little bit then.
Elevated. How can my diamonds and my cars help your life get situated? You ain't saying shit in your songs, that's why your life faded. 2 weeks after they dropped that trash, it was outdated.
Yeah, so that's basically the same. He said, you know, these guys that are fucking, they've got the cars, they've got the money, they've, you know, they've, but you know, they ain't saying shit in the songs. There's no fucking substance. Just the talking bollocks. And after you drop that shit, yeah, might get a little bit of money for it, but it's outdated. Other people dropping stuff that takes over, you know.
2 weeks after they dropped that trash, it was outdated. When platinum turned your back on the hood, you violated. If you don't show love to your fans, then you need to be castrated. Or you fell off.
Oh, so Jay, you might have gone platinum, but oh. Since you might have gone platinum, but you turned your back on the hood. You turned your back on where you came from. Yeah, that's something you never do, you know, because where you came from and your background or whatever, that makes you the person that you are. That sort of like gives you the motivation to become the person or do the things in life, you know, that makes you whatever. You fucking. Turning your back on the guys that you grew up with or whatever, and you don't show no love to your fans. You take the money, but you don't show no love. And for that, you should be castrated. Those balls chopped off. It's a bit harsh. It's a hard sentence, you know. You don't probably sell a little bit less stuff, but I'm not so sure that having your balls chopped off's the way forwards.
That you need to be castrated. You fell off and went broke, embarrassed and degraded. Your career was like an illusion that you hallucinated. From day one in the game, on thin ice you skated. And when you finally fell through, the community celebrated. They wanna check it.
I really want to know who he's going at, because he's giving somebody some absolute fucking life lessons here. You know, saying that when your career ended. Yeah, it was just a fucking illusion that you created yourself. In other words, you thought you were, whoever he's talking to, thought he were bigger than what he is, or what he was, and then this shit spiraled downhill, and skating on thin ice. And when his shit went through, when he fell through that ice, the whole community celebrated. The whole community pointed as one and laughed at him. It's giving someone some shit here, man. It's gotta be hard though to be at the top than to be at the bottom. That fucking like dude, fucking Takeshi. You know, he went at the top. He was fucking making millions, and now sat in court every week. You know, he's fucking snitching. His reputation's gone. Record deal's gone. Music career gone. Fucked it all up.
They wanna check and try me, try to crucify me, but when I hit them blindly, they be screaming, why me, why respect deny me, unaware that I be, liberty, the coldest you doubt and reply, see, they wanna check and try me, try to crucify me, but when I hit them blindly, they be screaming, why me, why respect deny me, unaware that I be, liberty, the coldest you doubt and reply, see.
Obviously, I'm not so sure when this track came out, but this sounds like proper, maybe late 90s, early 2000s, you know, sort of feeling to it, you know, with a background music or whatever, and you know, went through a stage where people were angry, weren't they? You know, there were a lot of underground rappers and whatnot whatnot, you know, coming through slightly, you know. So your likes are fucking, it's almost got, somebody's probably going to fucking say something to me about this, but it's almost got like a Wu-Tang feeling to it. You know what I mean? That sort of era feel to it. Anyway, guys, that's all I'm done. if you don't agree with me with what I've just said about the Wu-Tang thing, yeah, don't shout at me in the comments. But to me personally, it's, I'm not saying that it's the exact same or not like that, but it's just got, you know, that sort of era feel to it to me. Anyway, guys, like I said, that's it. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Oh, you want dropping, just let me know and I'll get to it as soon as I can. Thanks to everybody that's watched till the end as well. You know, I keep forgetting to thank yous all. And I'll see you guys on the next one.